the Shitcase Cinema.
Sinbad.
No, not Sinbad.
Oh yeah, this is Shitcase Cinema Gold if there ever was such stuff. So that means you're gonna love this film. So let's get the ball rolling and say hello to the one and only Sinbad. Yeah, I know it's the Incredible Hulk minus his green paint. Look, he's even got the same purple pants too, but don't complain. Lou Ferrigno really brings out some fine acting chops in this epic movie. You just wait and see. Now, the movie is told from the point of view of this woman reading her daughter a bedtime story in dramatic fashion.
It's an Arabian Nights tale about a sailor named Sinbad.
Sinbad?
Yes.
And if you don't find the acting and bad dubbing amusing, then this film just isn't for you. Maybe it is, what do I know? I don't know who it's for, but I'm sure he's got some kind of following in some dark hidden corner of the world. So every hero has a gang, and here's Sinbad's bunch of goons that hang around with him, and who are they, oh wise storyteller?
The young Ali, son of a great king. The Viking warrior, Poochie the dwarf. The bald cook, and the Chinese soldier of fortune.
Thanks. So an evil chap called Jafar decides to cause some havoc, and when he's not talking to the cameraman, he sends a storm into the kingdom to destroy it.
The black winds of pure evil blew through the town, bringing with them destruction and misery.
Yeah, well, all I see are people running around and trashing stuff like a bunch of football hooligans. So Jafar brainwashes the caliph and kidnaps the princess so he can marry her or something, which sets the scene for Sinbad to kick some ass, and whenever he fights you can really get the feel of the moment with realistic cracks, booms, moans and punches. Amazing. So Sinbad walks into a trap here, does a pretty decent impression of Arnold Schwarzenegger. And he's seemingly stuck in this dungeon trapped with snakes. Now get ready for one of the most stupidest moments, not only in this film, but in any film that I've ever reviewed over the years. He befriends the snakes by talking to them as you do, normal, and then he ties them together to make a rope to escape.
Hey, don't worry. I'm not gonna hurt you.
Well, it's a bloody good job they're clearly made from rubber, Sinbad, otherwise that'd make you one lying son of a bitch. Meanwhile, his other friends are caught by Jafar's guards after a lackluster fight and they're sent to be tortured. Oh no.
Put slant eyes in the hot seat and warm up the branding irons.
Slant eyes, what a name. But I'm sure this film is spot on with its depiction of races and names, the clothes they wear, not to mention the story this is based on, which brings me to number one on my top 10 highlights. Apparently it's based on a story by Edgar Allan Poe, but that's complete horseshit. Hell, the film even begins by telling you about the author. See, the comedy begins from the get-go. So Sinbad shows off his muscles, and when I say that, I mean it literally. Just check this out. Everyone else is watching on like, what the fuck are you doing, Sinbad? But he defeats these random goons and everyone is freed, so that's good. Happy times. While this goes on, Jafar has a goal of destroying 5 gems. Now, I don't know what they'll do if he can't destroy them, but he sends 4 of them away. Far, far away.
But Mommy, where are the sacred gems?
Sinbad didn't know.
But Mommy...
Now you must be patient, sweetie.
Annoying little brat, it's a bedtime story. Shut up and listen. So obviously Sinbad has to get these gems before the time runs out, so expect to see some awesome fight choreography and scary ass costumes, like you're back at junior school doing drama thinking that you're going to aspire to become an actor, but instead you just look like an asshole. Now once his battle is over, the dwarf comes out to deliver his best line. One of his only lines, but you know, whatever, it's just nitpicking.
What's with you guys? You look like a bunch of weirdos. Hey!
You missed one hell of a party.
Darn!
The dialogue is something else. This film is obviously aimed at very young children, with no swearing and words like darn. But then, you get phrases like slant eyes and... this. Yeah. Now, a strange-looking oracle tells them where to find the sacred gems. Looks like Zardoz, but on a smaller budget. Hell, make that no budget, his mouth doesn't even move. May as well just show a guy the stone in front of his face and do a voiceover. Number 2, Jafar spends 95% of his time in this one location like they only had a limited budget and time frame. I don't believe that. This is clearly a mega summer blockbuster. Number 3, Piranha apparently look like rubber snake puppets if you believe this story. Speaking of budgets, do you like the first monster that Sinbad fights? This battle is painful to watch because it's slowed down by about 3 or 4 speeds. It's ridiculous. So he smashes the Rockman to pieces and takes the gem to his friends.
Boy, that was a close call.
Now strangely, they don't know where to go next, but as they're just off the coast of this island, Sinbad decides to go there.
Which is where the Oracle said we would find the second gem.
What? So if the papier-mâché Zardos head told him to go there, why the hell are you debating where to go? Hulk, your head is just a fucking extension of your muscles. This film is so fragmented and has huge plot holes in there, but thankfully if you're struggling to understand or follow things, you have the mother explaining everything all the time. It's meant to be for the benefit of the kid, but you know the filmmakers knew that nobody would understand this fucking mess. It's for our benefit, let's not kid ourselves here. Does it help? Not one goddamn bit. You just want the mother to knock the kid out and stop reading.
Sinbad.
And you know, this is one long-ass bedtime story. Who the hell reads to a kid for 90 minutes? Just pick up that big beastly book and brain the little bitch. Job's a good one. Number 4, Jafar tells the princess his evil plot and randomly laughs, and you'll be laughing too afterwards.
Not even his friend Sinbad, a man who I hate more than hate itself, will stand between me and my heart's desire!
Ha! Number 5, Sinbad is super useless and clumsy. He always gets knocked around easily by the bad guys, loses his sword like an amateur, and here he even loses it himself. Look! Number 6,
Sinbad had to swim many leagues to the rocky shore where no ship could land.
He had to swim where the ship couldn't go. What, they couldn't take him further so he wouldn't have to swim many leagues? One league is over 5 miles, so he swam at least 10 miles. His so-called friends must be laughing their asses off at this gullible bastard. Number 7, for a film released in 1989, it makes sod and sandal films from the 50s look far superior. Number 8, Sinbad decides to talk to the camera, just because.
You're losing your power, Jafar. And you know that.
Number 9, if slow motion is your thing, then A, you'll love this movie, and B, you're a moron. You could even slow it down to half speed, I guess, to get twice as much fun. Bingo. Number 10, Sinbad can blow up hot air balloons and make them fly just because this film makes perfect sense. They find gem number 2 on the island of Amazon women. Now they're all caught and Sinbad is hypnotised and tortured by bad dancing, but the bald cook and the dwarf save them by using magic potion, and then Sinbad just grabs a gem and this woman turns old. Okay.
No! He's got the second gem!
Jafar is joined by a guy. Oh, sorry, it's a woman. Now, she's called Sucre and doesn't seem to care much for Jafar's nonsense.
You must be second to someone. Why not me?
Have you taken your medication this morning?
I can trust no one, let alone a woman!
No, Jafar. I'm different and you know it.
Yeah, we know. You're a man. So moving on, Jafar shows off more top-notch acting.
I call upon the winds of utter destruction.
Even Sinbad, the greatest sailor of all the seas, could not prevail.
And man alive, just look at that gale force wind rocking the boat. That's power. George Clooney had it easy, I can tell you that. So they're stranded on yet another island now, and here they fight dead knights, which takes forever to get going as there's more painful slow motion scenes, like it's the only thing they could think of to heighten the tension. But they win naturally, oh yeah, but then Jafar uses his powers to make Sinbad's crew teleport back out to sea. Hang on, I recognise that sound effect, that's from the trailer of Zardoz. Wow. Oh, and Sinbad kicks ass as usual in glorious slow motion. I love it. I also love how his hands don't get cut off, but let's not nitpick. It's not nitpicking anyway, it's just stating the obvious. Today on Channel Obvious, Meathead doesn't get his hands cut off on sword. Tune in next week. But before you know it, Sinbad meets this guy who looks like his tash is drawn on. Another Zardoz reference there, obviously. And he teams up with Tashman's daughter to get the last gem by fighting what is basically the rock monster, but with green slime covering it. Remember, low budget. Now the slime monster shoots laser beams at anything but Sinbad while he stands around like a fanny, but then he uses his 3 magic gems to shoot his own laser beams. What?
Now, Jafar, You're next.
Has he spotted a surveillance camera or something? Basically, he's just turned into a wall like this and talking to it in the hope that Jafar has somehow got his ability to see him directly in the face. Which he does, but whatever. So now that he's got these four gems, get ready for the finale, because it's pathetic. Sinbad loses his sword as usual. Check. Sinbad's stuck in a magic cave where the footage keeps reversing. Check. Twice the amount of bad acting as he fights himself now.
After I defeat you, I'll be the most powerful force in the universe!
Definite check on that. And more slow motion. Check. So Sinbad throws his bad hair dude clone into the fire. Kinda reminds me of Commando with the phasers they're pulling. The princess is free from the brain drain machine. Yeah, seriously, that's what this apparently is. Why she couldn't escape early is beyond me. And why can he brainwash the Caliph in a second, yet take the entire duration of the movie to brainwash the princess with a machine? That's not nitpicking, that's just stating the obvious again. And that's the end.
And then, our story ends here.
Now get to sleep, you little fucker. Even though it's clearly daylight outside, but still. So I'm going to give this 2 out of 10. One for each of Sinbad's man boobs. And of course the unintentional laughs.